Hi, it's Kev Scott here. If you have a dual monitor arrangement, it can be nice to have wallpapers that show places you have been rather than the standard ones that can be downloaded from a number of websites. The images that you can see cycling here on my screens, these are sped up by the way, are some of the ones that I have taken as I have travelled around, and it is a nice reminder of these places when they pop up. In this video I will show you how to make these on Windows 10 and talk a bit about the software that can be used to help with the process. It is an easy thing to do and I hope you agree as we step through it. Okay, let's get started. The first thing to do is determine the size of the image needed. The easiest way to do this is to find a blank bit of your screen and right click the mouse, then select Display Settings as you can see here. Having done that, we get the following screen. Selecting display 1 and scrolling down, we see it is 1920 by 1080. And then selecting display 2, we see it is 1920 by 1080 as well. So adding these two together, we, in this case, need to produce an image that is 1920 plus 1920 by 1080. So it's 3840 by 1080. This is quite a common format, as is the one associated with slightly deeper screens, 3840 by 1200. Your screen may be one of these sizes, or it may be some other size, but the approach is the same. We are now going on to crop an image to this size. To crop the image, we are going to use Paint 3D. The reason we are using that program is that it is one of the few programs built into Windows 10 that I know of that allows you to specify the crop size. When I first open the picture, Windows will open it by default in the Photos app. If you have reprogrammed your file associations and it is opened by something else, I recommend you open the Photos app and then load the image from within it. This photo that I am editing here is from a place called the Hermitage, which is in Perthshire in Scotland. The photo was taken from a bridge using the panorama feature on my smartphone, and I rotated through 180 degrees, so the path on the left and on the right are from the same bridge. Selecting Edit with Paint 3D causes that app to be started up, and we then select Crop and we get to this screen. You will see there are a number of preset shapes available to us, but for what we are trying to do, we should select Custom. Then go to the menu on the right and specify our sizes, in this case 3840 and 1080. It's important to lock the aspect ratio so that the shape of the rectangle remains the same. You can now move the rectangle around until you're happy with the image, as I am doing here. I want to leave the bridge on the left out, so let's move it over here a bit. If you want to capture more of the image, it is okay to make the rectangle larger, as can be seen here. Windows will still be happy with that and display it as if our original size. You can also select an image smaller than the original size as well, like I am showing here, but you will get a much more grainy picture, and for that reason it is not recommended. Okay. Now I'm happy with it, I select Done. I now select Menu, then Save As, then select Image. I am going to save it in my Pictures area, and I am going to create a new folder called My Wallpapers. Having saved it, we are taken back to the main screen and we can just exit. We get prompted that we haven't saved the original image, but as we have saved it already in a different location, we can just ignore this. All we now need to do is set Windows up to display this. What we need to do now is tell Windows where to get our wallpapers from. To do this, right-click on a free part of your desktop and select Personalize. If you just want to see one picture, then select Picture in this menu and go to the My Wallpapers folder and select the image we have just created. However, it can be nice to have these changing as you use the PC. If you want to do that, then select Slideshow and choose the same folder and choose how often you want them to change. If you select Shuffle, then it will randomise the order in which these are shown. In addition to the Hermitage picture that we added earlier, I've added a few others. Final selection is a fit. You should choose Fill, as all of the pictures we are storing in here have been adjusted already to fill the screen. That's it. Now just sit back and enjoy seeing pictures of your favourite places on your desktop. If you did find this video useful, please consider hitting the like button, and if you would like to see more videos of this type in the future, please consider subscribing. See you soon!